Welcome. Today we're going to show you how to put together a awesome competitive analysis using SEMrush. So in essence, what we're looking to do is take a look at how are you doing in terms of search engine optimization and paid search, and then to also look at perhaps you'd be able to run as many competitors as you like when you do this. I'm going to be using an example of running an analysis for Mercury Marine today. And so this also will be used for internal training, so some parts of this video may not apply to the outside world, but we do this all the time. If you don't have access to this awesome SEMrush tool and aren't able to get the data that you want at any point in time, feel free to reach out to us. We'll do this for you guys at no cost. So happy to start some relationships and then kind of see where it goes from there. So without further ado, what I'll do is go ahead, we'll start off with Mercury Marine. Plug them in, as so. As we see, that blue line is the organic traffic that they're receiving. This is not direct traffic, this is not referral traffic or social media traffic, this is specifically someone went to Google, because right now we're hovered over US Google. This is someone that went to Google, typed in a keyword that Mercury Marine ranks for, and went back to the site. And these are estimates. Obviously, SEMrush doesn't have access to Mercury Marine's analytics. What they're able to do is look at, here's the keywords that they're ranking for, here's the positions that they're sitting in, the search volumes for those phrases, and they're able to apply an industry standard click-through rate based on the position that they're in. So they're able to estimate about how much organic traffic they're receiving. And then it also does track paid campaigns, which doesn't look like Mercury Marine at this time is really running much of a paid campaign. So that data says nothing found down here. That is that orange line. But the organic keywords, they have 13,049 different keywords on the first 10 pages of Google. This used to be, they only used to report to the first 3 pages, but I think about a month ago they updated and have launched out to the first 10 pages. And so when we export this, it's going to export the first 30,000. So Mercury Marine only has 13,000, so it'll acquire the whole list, export that. And but if you're trying to do an analysis for Walmart or, you know, something really big, obviously going to pull back just the first 30,000. It does down here tell us other competitors in organic search, you know, boats.net, marineengine.com, Evinrude, etc. But they went ahead and gave us the competitors that they wanted us to look at. So we'll look at, and I'm using Libre Office, Calc, to do all this. It pulls in a lot of different information. It pulls in your keyword, pulls in the position that you're in. So you'll see that a keyword may actually appear multiple times in this list, but the position is going to change. Obviously, it's our brand name. That's most of the time that what you're going to see, most of the duplicate keywords are around brand names, but you'll see that the URL specifically changes based on you know, what position they're in. So position one is just the main domain. If we found that down below, it would go to a different page. I'm going to be doing some training on how I want these reports prepped internally for our prospects and whenever we do this complimentary. So the way I like to do this is I like to specifically look at, you know, what position you're in right now. So we'll remove previous position. And then everything to the right, to be honest, not too worried about in our reports. So we focus on the main metrics. So we'll get rid of that and we'll delete all that. So you have the first tab in essence. We're going to add a tab down here, Sheet 2, rename that. We're going to call that health report, because I actually want to just give a snapshot of every single client or every single of their competitors and how they're doing. Just one easy little report that they'll be able to look at. The first thing, and again internal, go to initial market research new. You'll find that server sales med market research initial market research new. Sort by type, and you'll find these various images. So go ahead and take that image, paste it in, and so we'll make this nice and branded. What we'll also want to do is we'll put company, we'll put keywords, page one, we'll put paid search, estimated spend. So for the first company, it's mercurymarine.com. I always recommend, instead of hand typing it, go ahead and copy and paste it. Get rid of everything before the W's. Or so. We'll rename this tab as well. mercurymarine.com-SEO. Okay. What we're going to do is we're also going to control A, control, and click the first row so you unselect it. Data, sort. We're going to sort by position, ascending. So we want to then find, scroll down. Position 1 through 10 is what's on the first page of Google. So when we get to position 11, they have 4,129 keywords on the first page of Google. Why is it not 4,130? Because of that top row where it details its keyword and such. So we'll take that, 4,129, which is obviously a lot less than the total number of keywords they have. So you can't use that 13,049 number. You have to specifically sort to find this. And then estimated spend for them at this moment in time is $0 for on the paid side, because they're not running any paid, it looks like. And then we also want to go ahead and take a snapshot of this graph. So you can use whatever program you like. Some people like Snagit. So I'm using just the snipping tool that comes with Windows. Edit, copy. Go back to report and you throw in the graph. All right, excellent. So we'll take this, move it down here, and then we'll do our next one. So let me go over to, they wanted Yamaha outboards, so we'll throw that in. By the way, you cannot have http://www. It will actually throw off this report, so I recommend stripping that out. Here, I'll just do it so you can see. It doesn't actually produce anything, so strip everything out just to the .com. And now we have our graph, which, let's go ahead and get rid of the original one. Let's snip this next one. Excellent. Edit, copy. Paste it in. So we'll go ahead and export. They are running a paid campaign, as you can see from that orange or yellow line. We can export organic keywords, and we can export their ad keywords. So now both have appeared down below. Go ahead and open them up. And if you are using LibreOffice, it likes to do a little pop-up, so you might have to look at anything that's currently open. Here it is, here's that pop-up. Okay. Second one will pop up. And if you're not sure, you know, the reports, what you're looking at, you can always look up at the top, just look at the title, Domain AdWords, that's the paid search campaign that they're running. So we'll take all that, get rid of this sheet, go back to our report that we're building, add another tab, go ahead and paste it in. So I like keeping the title and description. That is the actual ad copy that Yamaha Outboards is currently using for that keyword. I get rid of previous position. Sometimes that's good to know. If their previous position 0, that means they weren't previously advertising on it. And then everything after visible URL, I go ahead and remove. Actually, that is incorrect, sorry. I get rid of everything after visible URL, except for the actual full URL that is useful information. Because the visible URL may not actually lead to the URL that the user will actually see when they click the ad. So it doesn't look like I got rid of everything like I needed to. Let's delete those columns. Very good. So now we have Yamaha Outboard, which we'll go ahead and just take one of those URLs, copy, rename the sheet down here. And then we'll make a new tab. Also get the SEO. Get rid of that previous position. And everything right. Delete. Okay. And then again, Control A. While holding Control, click the first row, data sort based on position, oops, ascending. Okay. And we want to scroll down to when we see the first number 11. There you go. So they have 2,544 keywords on the first page of Google. 2,544. The estimated paid spend, so you know where to get that. SEMrush is not exactly accurate in terms of ads traffic price. However, they're estimating they're spending about $4,000. Instead of being specific when presenting this, you know, with the exact number that SEMrush gives, I decide to actually put in an estimate. So what we'll do is we'll put about $4,000 a month. Okay. And then for the company, we'll rename the sheet while we're here. Rename. Excellent. And I'm particular, I like SEO to be the tab that comes before. And so we'll put, again, Yamaha Outboards there. Very good. And so you can continue to repeat the process with all the competitors, you know, continuing to add to your health report with the various graphs, which you'll want to center this information so it looks a little bit better. And you might even want to bold the headers. Do that again. Oops. There we go. One of the things I also like to do, though, is specifically pull out what's on page two. Okay, so we'll scroll down to positions 11 through 20. We'll copy that information. We'll make a new sheet after. I call it the Great Opportunities tab because this is the area that, if given a little bit more time and effort, if we take the time to push up what's on page two to page one, I'm going to grab this header row and take it over, insert a new row here. But if we take the time to move what's on page two to page one, and this is the stuff that Google sees you as an authority, you're oh so close. If you move from page two to page one, you're going to naturally see a very large increase, because the majority of users obviously do not go to page two. You can look up the industry standard, click the rates on that. I won't try to quote any of those stats. But what I do in this report is I actually sort this two ways. In the meeting, I'll actually, when presenting this, I'll sort it based on search volume to go and descending to look at, you know, what do we got that we could really make a movement on that could have a pretty large impact. You know, these are position 11. That's great. Now, remember I said that there might be duplicate keywords, so some of these may in fact be on page one. You know, boat motors, for example, might be on page one, etc. But this is a good place to kind of start the conversation. And so I'll sort it that way. And then during the meeting, I'll also sort by cost per click, because those are the keywords the industry says are super valuable. I'll sort it, you know, by the highest cost per click first. You know, if they're willing to pay that and we're on page two, you know, if they're willing to pay $5 for it, $10, $20, et cetera, depending on the industry, then maybe there's a reason that we want to move that up actually quicker than the ones that, you know, have a lot of search volume, but we could easily buy. So that's how you run a preliminary analysis. And then for to wrap up the internal training, what you'll do is you'll save as. You'll go into, again, that server, sales, mad market research, initial market research, new. Now, do yourself a favor. Do not save as CSV. Always make sure you save as XLSX. You save as CSV, what will happen is you will lose all the tabs except for the very first one. Don't want to make that mistake. So Mercury Marine dash preliminary analysis dash, and of course I like to add our brand, that company, to any report that goes out. So, and we'll save. All right, very good. Hope you found this to be informative, and I hope that this helps you when putting together competitive research on, you know, whether it's for a prospect or whether it's you're just doing this internally. If you would like any assistance, as I mentioned, this is something that we do complimentary all the time for, you know, anybody that's looking for digital marketing assistance. So my name is Michael Knorr. I'm the Director of Partnership Development over here at that company, and happy to help. Have a great day.